Hi, it's Pamela. Today I'm going to make a Christmas table runner. I've used some lovely festive greens and reds and creams, but I've also got some modern grey in my mixture, and it'll look great on my red tablecloth this Christmas. It doesn't take very long to do, and I hope you'll make one as well. I've started with an 11-inch square for the centre part of my table runner, and I've cut 11-inch strips, which I'm going to build up along the sides till I get to the length I want. So I've pre-cut them all 11 inches this way, and they're varying between 2.5 and 3 inches wide, and I'm going to sew them all together. And at the very end I've got a triangle, which just makes it a more traditional shape. The triangle at the end is 11.5 inches wide in order to accommodate that join at the end. Because it's cut away on a diagonal, it needs to be a little longer so that it matches where the seam ends. I should have said that all my fabrics are cotton. They work well together. They're all a similar weight. They'll wash, and it works really well to use cotton. So you could try it with other things, but I'm sticking to cotton today. So I'm going to start by joining all these pieces up to get a long strip. So that's the first piece joined on. I've done it right sides together, and I've used 1/4 inch seam allowance right the way along. And now I'm ready to do my next one. I'll add on my next strip. That's that piece on, and I'll just cut my threads. I tend to cut my threads as I go using the machine snip. So now we're ready for the triangle piece that goes on at the end. So that's slightly longer. Remember I said to cut that 11.5 inches rather than 11. So make sure the tails are hanging over the edge just a smidge. It'll be about 1/4 inch hanging over the edge at both sides. And that means it's the same length where the stitch takes place. So I'm going to set the seams, and that's by pressing them the way they've been stitched. So I'm just looping it over, folding it down, and pressing the way they've been stitched. It sets the stitches and it just makes it all a bit tidier. There we go. And the next thing I'm going to do is press the seams all in one direction. In patchwork we tend not to press the seams open, we press them away. So if I lift it up and the seam allowance is lying that way, it just naturally goes like that. I bring the iron up to it and push away, and that presses the seam to one side, and I'm set to go to the next one. Pushing back along. There we are, and I'll just check that they're all going in the right direction. Yes, they're pretty much there. I'll just tidy that up a little bit, short of steam. There we are, so that's one side of the table runner done, and it will join on to the centre square, and obviously we have to do that again for the other side. I've decided to decorate this a little bit. I think it would benefit from a wee bit decoration. So what I've done is I've cut out I drew a little holly shape, and I've cut out some felt, green felt with the holly shapes, and I thought I would put them on the grey parts of the fabric. It's just going to brighten it up and make it a bit more fun. So this is how I did it. I got my two holly pieces and I'm going to put them on like that. So I'll pin them in place, and I've changed over to a green thread to match. So it'll look quite neat. And I'm just going to do a line down the centre of the holly leaf. That's it, that's both the holly leaves on here. That's quite pretty. I've cut out some red berries as well, I'll add them in a moment. But I decided, I quite like this felt holly leaf, so I've put it on my centre square as well. I've cut out a whole lot of them and arranged them in a wreath-like pattern to sit in the centre of my table runner, and that leaves a nice space here for putting a plant or candles or whatever in the middle of your table, because we normally have some sort of decoration on the table even when it's not being used over the festive period. So that's what I'm going to do. So my next stage is to join on my side pieces to my centre square, and that's just the same way as I did the strips, with a quarter of an inch seam on the sewing machine. I'm just thinking about where I want to put the holly berries. I've cut out lots of red circles to be the berries, and I'm just not sure how I want to arrange them, so I'm just playing about with them at the moment. I've added the berries now. I did go ahead and put them on. I've put them in an abstract sort of way. It's just a pleasing finish rather than try and get them all in exactly the right place. I've just made a pleasing design. I've used a simple running stitch across the middle of the berry, just rotating the machine. I didn't even cut the threads until I was finished. I just moved it along to the next one rather than getting involved in machine embroidery at this stage. I thought I would keep it quite simple. So I did the same with the ends. I put a couple of berries in either end. And next I've layered up with a wadding and a backing fabric. This is a lightweight wadding, and I've got a nice red cotton backing fabric. And I'm going to use the turn it through method rather than binding all this. I don't think it needs a border on it. I'm just going to stitch right round. So I've turned this one over and I'm going to leave a gap for turning it through. I'm going to pin it round and then stitch it. Right, we've machined all the way round and I'm just cutting the backing cloth and the wadding to fit. If you can see closer, I'm cutting it the size of the top fabric, the table runner that we've assembled, but at the points I'm coming in just closer so that we get a good point when we turn it through. If it's got bulk in that point, it won't turn through smoothly. I might have to trim the wadding up slightly smaller as well, but we'll cut it all to the size of the table runner top. Right, so I went right the way round, trimming off the excess backing and wadding, and I flipped it over and I'm trimming again just to take the wadding back a bit in order that we can turn it through more successfully. So that's that done. So we'll try and flip it through now. I've got a gap here and I'm going between the backing and the top fabric. There we are. We'll get a pointed something or other to get the end nice and neatly. I think I'll use the point of my scissors. If the scissors are closed, they won't be too sharp. So we'll take that in right to the end. Get a good clean point without poking and making a hole. There we are, that looks quite good. And into the other end. That looks pretty good. And so next thing, I'll press it all and decide what sort of quilting I need to do. I don't want to do too much quilting, but we'll need to attach the layers across the width of the cloth in some fashion. So I'll do the ironing and I'll get back to you. Well, that's it finished. All you need to do is do a few hand stitches along the edge to close the seam where you turned it through. I've pressed it so that we can't see the backing fabric. I've tried to get the crease right, the stitch line exactly at the edge, and I'm really pleased with it. I've put it out on top of this red fabric just to show it off at its best. It didn't look very glamorous on my mat. I'm not even too sure that it needs any quilting. I'm quite happy with that the way it is. And if I sound surprised, it's because I was sort of making it up as I went along. I had a rough idea of what I wanted to do, but I've added the holly just because it needed something to lift it. So I'm delighted. I hope you try and do one yourself. Let me know.